Welcome back to another video. Today I want to show you how you can create small little percussion loops with Bitwig Studio without using any samples. Just a bit of grid magic for your techno tracks or minimal tracks, something like along those lines. So I want to show you how this works and let's start. Use my code Polarity in the shop to save 10% on the price and support my channel. We actually need some kind of kick drum. So I load here the e-kick of Bitwig Studio. Maybe I resize the interface here a little bit so you can see it better. And maybe lay down here some kicks. Just to have some kind of rhythm. Okay, so let's imagine you need a lot of percussions and usually you go into your sample library and load up a lot of different percussion sounds and then you kind of place them on the arranger. And I want to show you how you can do this with the Bitwig internal devices. So we can use here the eTom device, which gives you some kind of tom, and you can tweak it here to your liking. Maybe I turn on my keyboard. So let's try this. So you can tune it. Can set your the pitch modulation. And that's all nice. But even nicer is that you can use the polygrid. And then use the eTom and put it into the FX slot here. Maybe delete the grid out. You have basically polygrid in the FX section. You have now the eTom device. And what you can do is you can modulate all these parameters here. So let's set them to 0. Maybe this, or maybe let's go to this. All to 0. And then you add a lot of dice devices here and maybe a button, something like this. Connect these two and then you need at least one modulator out here. And then you can modulate all the parameters of the eTom device. So for instance, like this, a tune and maybe a decay. Also the amount, and maybe we can also change here the decay. Then connect all these dices here with the button. And when you press the button here, you get a lot of different sounds. So when you lay down here all these, maybe let's remove here the decay a little bit, or at least narrow down the range of the decay modulation here. So now you have, can by just pressing this button, you get different percussion sounds. And we can use here a button, modulate with this button inside the grid, and call this generate. Now we can generate a new tom sound by just pushing this button here. Okay, so now that we have this, we can remove here all the notes and just use one note and use an arpeggiator in front of this polygrid. Okay, so now we have a rhythm with some different drum sounds we can change by pressing this button here. And what we do now is we use an instrument selector. This should do it. Instrument selector. And then we just put this polygrid into this selector here. So we have one layer And what we do now is we use again a button modulator here in front of the instrument selector and modulate the generate button of this one layer. And we also call it maybe global generate, something like this. And then we can just duplicate this track here four times, or this layer four times, and select the instrument selector itself and switch it to round robin. And we press here the GI generate. And what it does is basically you generate a different sound for each layer here because it's all random, right? We have now multiple polycrit devices here. Every polycrit device has its own dice, which got triggered. And then we have multiple different sounds on each layer. And this sounds like this. And then you can use the bass drum here again. Okay, and when you remove certain layers here, for instance, this one, you have only three, then you have a pattern of three different sounds repeating, which gives you some kind of polyrhythm because three is not even. Or I can use a 5, which is also possible. Okay, when you have this, you can duplicate this and have then two different selectors here, or two tracks of these, and then you can combine maybe 6 pattern steps with 3 pattern steps here. And you get kind of interesting patterns with different percussion sounds. You can even develop this even more by just adding effects, clippers, and distortion effects, and modulate or randomly change these sounds by pressing this button. So you get a lot of interesting techno percussions this way, right? Also use this, or can use the head device here and modulate all the parameters. In fact, we can do this right now because it's my video and I can do what I want. So polygrid, put this in here, delete the grid node out because I don't need it, put all the parameters here to 0 so we can modulate it easily. Maybe also this is good, maybe go to 30. Okay, so let's use a button here. Let's use a dice. And let's use a modulator. And then modulate all these parameters. It's a bit of work, but you can save this as a preset, of course, and recall it every time you need it to make some interesting sounds quick. Yeah, that's right. So let's try this for the start. Connect these. So, okay. Now we have this, we need of course a button here. Modulate this button, call this generate, and maybe use an arpeggiator in front. And just use one note here. And maybe you can also modulate this parameter, which can also be interesting. Okay. Okay. So now we use again an instrument selector. Instrument selector, put this in here, duplicate this, or just use a button here, a global generate button, modulate this. That's okay. Okay, now we can duplicate this here and switch this to round robin. Maybe use a hard clip device. The only downside to this is that that the polygrid basically doesn't save the states or the values of the generated values of the dice module. So every time you load up this project, you get different values here, or you have to re-trigger with the button actually to modulate something. So there's no save. You have to bounce this down to audio if you want to persist this with the project save. But you can see, you can come up with a lot of different sounds, percussion sounds, pretty quickly. Then you can just bounce this down to post fader here, and then you have a new asset you can use in your tracks, or in this track specifically, or just use it to arrange it. So you have in one part you have this sound, and in another part you just generate a new loop. So for instance, you just sample this. So you have in one part you have this line, and another part you have this line, so you can alternate between the two. Also, you can of course change this to. So you can basically edit the audio file again and maybe reverse it. So there are a lot of possibilities. So you can generate your own percussion loops just with the Bitwig devices and the polygrid by randomly modulate all the parameters. Use here the instrument selector to create some patterns with the arpeggiator. So it's pretty easy to do. You can save it all as a preset, recall it every time, and basically make 20 minimal techno tracks a day if you want. So this video initially should be a Bitwig tips and tricks video, where I share multiple small tips and tricks for Bitwig Studio, but this trick got actually so long that I thought maybe it's better to do a separate video on it. So this is the tutorial on how to create minimal percussions with Bitwig internal devices. And yeah, thanks for watching. Please leave a like if you liked the video, subscribe to the channel, and maybe think about a membership on Patreon or here on YouTube to support my content. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video. Bye.